Jacob opened the door of his apartment. He entered first, and I, Van, followed him. Jacob exchanged glances with the bodyguards and the left. This wasn't the first time I came into his apartment. This was the second time. And this time, he took his time to offer me a pair of slippers. I looked at the slippers. Those were clean but not brand new. I lowered my head. Thank you. I and Nona both live in this apartment, but most of the time we have to live alone as we come here separately. I and Nona both respect our privacy, so I won't go to her room and discover her slippers. These are my ones. You can have this, Jacob uttered in a stern voice. My throat felt a little dried up, and that made me cough a few times. Before I could say anything, I noticed a tensed bunny boy hurried to the kitchen and brought me a glass of water. Drink it. A hint of anger with a lot of care and concern was obvious in his tone. Come on, Van, you have never analyzed anybody's behavior like this. He is just concerned. I stopped myself from overthinking. Jacob gently tapped and rubbed my back.
Drink slowly.
I nodded. Aren't you angry anymore? By the way, why were you so angry? I asked, and his expressions changed immediately.
You are tired. You need rest. So am I. Let's go to the bedroom.
Fine here. I stammered. You have such a big living area, and this couch looks so cozy, and the temperature is pretty good. If I'm not wrong, it is our family's mutual decision why we are here, and you told yourself that I know you better than your mom. We are going to get married, and then we will be living under one roof in one room. As the announcement is done, and you came to my apartment yourself, then why would I let my fiancé to stay in this not so comfortable living room when we can share the bed? Even best friends can sleep in same bed. Then why can't we? Jacob raised his eyebrows. Dr. Chung, I know you are angry, but I don't know why you are angry. And if you think sharing a bed can protect our relationship from its certain annihilation, then, Dr. Chung, I must help you to open your eyes. The sweet talks, soft pillow fights, sour calls, and late-night cuddles can't make you a father. And primarily, what our family expects from us is inheritance. The perfect amalgamation of the Jones and the Kings. I told him calmly. Dr. Jung, you are normal, but you can't skip the fact that you are not aware of my condition. It's normal to be excited at your age, but at this point, I almost choked. Stop. Please at least pause for a moment. Do you think I'm pitying you and compromising with my married life? You are really genius, Miss Kim. Being a business person, you just clarified your stupid ideology of marriage in front of a gynecologist. Jacob chuckled. Miss Kim Van, I have gone through your reports when I didn't even know that you were the Miss Kim Van. Is the involuntary tensing or contracting of muscles around the infertility or problem with ovulation and are mutually independent problems for a woman. The way you described, it's not like that at all. One might have both the conditions and problems, but you have only, as your reports are still pretty normal. Who convinced you that you can't have a child or children of your own?
you can say that you and I are not compatible for each other. Even without giving us a chance, as your ego is the most precious ornament in your crown, Princess came. I, Wang, started feeling guilty at this point. I never got that much free time to think, to get engaged with a man or having my own little family. Projects after projects, meetings and the preps had made me so exhausted that I always prayed for extra 2 hours. I couldn't think when I was in a situation to choose the option to complete my sleep. I was always advised to take sufficient rest, but I never afforded that. Why? Stop. I'm sorry. Was I too harsh on you? A gentle touch on my cheeks dragged me into the reality. I didn't realize when my tears started flowing down my cheeks. Jungkook cupped my face and started wiping the salty water of sorrow. You wanna sleep here? In the living area? I mean, it's quite empty. You might get scared. Look, my bedroom is quite spacious. You can easily be fitted there. For one night to forever. Jungkook consoled me. I'm fine here. I'm a man of true words. Dr. Jun, I just want to rest tonight. I don't want to feel any tension, any awkwardness. And I don't want to be the reason of your awkwardness. You are also jet-lagged. Go and rest well. I told him in a cracked and shaky voice. Jungkook nodded. Okay, now close your eyes. He took my phone from my hand and put it aside. I hope you will not have any problem if I stay here with you.
Until you fall asleep? Wang closed her eyes. She could sense Jungkook's presence. Jungkook's fingers caressing her hair. Wang was used to with pillow while sleeping. That difference on the couch was really making hard for her to fall asleep. She moved a little and soon she could find her cozy, comfortable pillow position on the couch. As Jungkook placed her head on his lap. This feeling was not one way. This was more mutual one. As Wang found her comfort zone in his lap and Jungkook felt peace. Wang was already drowsy as Jungkook kept caressing her hair. Jungkook silently chuckled as he remembered how Wang demanded him to smile like a schoolboy. Pretend like I'm the girl of your dreams. Wang's lines echoed in his ears. He smiled and remembered how she called him bunny or bunny-teethed boy. Somewhere in his heart, Jungkook could find peace seeing her sleeping in his lap. The feeling was fulfilling to him that he was unaware of many things. Without realizing it all, he actually started falling in love with the girl inside her. Although he had already realized that Wang don't easily come out from her shell, but he had already started admiring the behavior of the tender-hearted girl. The clock was about to hit the midnight bell. Jungkook couldn't leave her in the living area just like that. He gave his brain a few minutes to think a plan, but as soon as his brain surrendered, he took her into his arms and carried her in bridal style to his room. For the first time, it was Jungkook who allowed any woman in his room, except his family. He laid down her on the bed and covered a thin sheet of fabric on her. He was unaware of Wang's sleeping patterns. Wang's sleeping patterns wasn't that much horrible, but she was used to with a big, soft side pillow. On the big bed, maintaining a distance, Jungkook laid on the other side of the bed. The diagonal sleeper backfaced the ceiling and closed his eyes.
It was around 8 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, sounds like quite late for a normal person.
For a doctor, it's hard to tell whether it's a dream or nightmare, because most of them can't afford that.
Jungkook yawned and opened his eyes.
He was feeling quite refreshed. Due to the pressure, tension and workload, he developed insomnia. He tried many tips and tricks, but nothing worked.
Do I need to be jet-lagged that bad?
He was about to stretch his arms when he finally felt bounded,
or felt nothing.
He couldn't feel his legs, his arms. All he could feel a heavy weight and being restricted. He took no time to discover the reason, as he felt a beat on the right side of his chest. Warm breathing pattern was constantly hitting on his neck area. A beautiful lady was embracing him tightly. A restlessness worked within him. He wanted to be detangled, yet he wasn't willing to disturb her sleep. He took his time to detach his body from her strong embrace as his legs and arms were numb. A chuckle escaped from his lips, thinking someone has the courage, the strength to make him feel weak. Jungkook placed her head on the pillow and soon went moved to adjust her position with her new cold cottony pillow. After a few moments, her breathing patterns became silent, normal. She went back to sleep again. Jungkook got up from bed. After completing his morning routine, he was all set to go to the kitchen to prepare breakfast or brunch, when he heard a phone ringing in the living area. It was Van's phone. Looking at the flashed screen, at first Jungkook hesitated, but as incoming call from the same number flashed more than two times, he thought it must be urgent. He touched the phone screen and received the call. "Yeboseyo,"
he uttered in his morning husky voice. Unfortunately, it was from one of the journalists, as the media was eagerly waiting for any response from Van's side. The call was disconnected immediately as the journalist had enough information, and that made Jungkook frown. What the hell? He noticed several missed calls from dad, mom. Jungkook took his phone from his pocket and dialed Mr. Kim's number.
"Mr. Kim, 여보세요?
Jungkook.
네, 안녕하세요. I'm John Jungkook.
Mr. Kim,
I know. Tell me, how are you? Is Van troubling you?
Jungkook.
I'm fine. I mean, we're fine. Van is not directly troubling me at all, but I am worried about things related to Van. Someone called Van multiple times. She's sleeping, so I received the call, but the person on the other end didn't respond. Just disconnected the call.
It was a time of apprehension, as Van was just a 22 years old girl.
"Let me check."
Mr. Kim spoke in a serious tone, but surprisingly, the old man chuckled as he noticed the news flashing on the TV screen, claiming Dr. John is taking good care of the business tycoon, Ms. Kim Van. Kim Van didn't allow anyone to answer her phone calls. It was the first time when someone answered her phone calls.
"Mr. Kim, don't worry, Jungkook. I think it was from media. She just saves the phone numbers of the person who is important to her, whom she would need to call from her side. She is too private as a person, but it doesn't mean she's a coward. Jungkook, please try to understand."
Jungkook. "I understand, Uncle. I was planning to prepare breakfast for us. This phone call thing delayed everything.
Uncle, what she likes to eat in her breakfast?"
"Mr. Kim,
as far as I know, she just eats to live. She eats like she doesn't have taste buds. She never complained about food, though the chef never forgets to ask her what she wants to eat every single day, almost 5 times a day. Jungkook, she takes 5 meals. Mr. Kim, in order to keep her healthy, keeping with times, the chef sends her 5 meals. It's the chef's initiative totally. Wen is too obedient and hopefully she isn't someone who wastes food. So she eats. Jungkook frowned as he found it wasn't that much positive attitude of Wen towards her own life. Okay, thank you, uncle. The call was disconnected.
Jungkook cooked something with the ingredients he had in his kitchen. He wasn't worried for whether Wen would like his food or not. He was worried for Wen's health. He decided to not to check the taste of the food before serving. He served the food and waited for Wen to wake up. And Wen finally opened her eyes. It was almost 12 o'clock, probably the first time in her life. She looked around and found herself in a bed. The room was quite dark. She tried to find her phone but groaned as she couldn't find anything. She sighed and rolled on the bed. She was about to execute her plan of sleeping like a lazy when the door of the room was opened.
The sudden exposure of light made her to close her eyes instinctively. No, she wasn't drunk. She didn't take even a sip of alcohol last night, but as the quality of last night's sleep was top-notch, that probably resisted her from panicking. When, hearing her name from a male voice, she almost jumped out of the bed. He wanted to scold her for many things, but looking at the confused, innocent, sleepy-faced pretty woman who had refused to accept the comfort he wanted to provide her, the bunny melted instantly. Good morning, Wen. Come on, I have made breakfast for us.
Where's my phone?
Wen asked him. Give me that. I need to know what's going on. By the way, what is the time?
Around 10 in the morning.
Jungkook informed.
What are you saying? I have overslept.
Wen sighed as she needed to figure out many things.
You are skipping your office. I have also cancelled all my appointments.
We can afford one day after all.
We are newly engaged couples. We must spend time with each other.
Jungkook softly said.
Dr. Jeon?
She was about to say something but immediately stopped by Cook.
Miss Kim, I need to monitor your morning routine. I hope you will cooperate me
as a patient.
What would I have to do? Wen asked.
First, do Kegel exercise by squeezing the same muscles you use to stop the flow when you are.
Squeeze those muscles.
Hold them for 2 to 10 seconds. Relax the muscle. Jungkook described, and that made Wen to jump out of the bed.
Where's the washroom?
What? Jungkook exclaimed as he wasn't ready for this kind of reaction.
Cause I am squeezing the same muscles you just mentioned.
Stupid bunny. Wen was too furious.
Oh, on your left.
Jungkook switched on the lights. Obviously, Wen hurried to the washroom for her morning routine. During this time, Jungkook made the bed, removed the curtains to let light into the room from the windows. Wen stepped out of the washroom, wearing the same clothes from last night. She thought that she would be going from here in no time, but her tummy growled.
Yeah, that would definitely be quite embarrassing for any woman.
Dr. Jeon, everything is going out of control.
I don't have my phone. so I don't know what is going on in the outer world. My brain is not functioning properly. I am craving for the bed, what I usually don't do. My tummy growled. Even I haven't heard it in a long time. There's nothing embarrassing, Van. Let's have some pre-workout meal and then we will do our respective morning exercise. Jacob spoke. It's not morning at all. Can't we skip it? Van whined. No, we can't. Jungkook strictly said, no more words, just follow me. Van followed Cook to the dining area obediently. They started eating the already cold food that Jungkook had prepared in the morning. After taking the first bite, Van scrunched her nose. I'm hungry, I don't want to eat this, I want tasty things. Jungkook also took a bite of the food he prepared and, to his surprise, the food tasted as it should be, neither bland nor spicy, just cold. But it didn't taste bad. It was quite surprising for Jungkook as the obedient, strict, well-mannered woman he had met suddenly started acting like a child. He didn't want her to act like the manual person she had become. Although her behavior surprised him at first, but as he thought about the morning, how she made him her side pillow, a smile line automatically curved his lips. Remembering the conversation with Mr. Kim, he decided to pamper her the way no one had. He realized they need to spend more time with each other in order to know each other. Dr. Jun, you are smiling. Van's words dragged him into the reality again. Finish your food and you will get to access your phone for next 30 minutes. After that, we will do our exercise and tonight, we will sleep a little earlier as early morning is the best time for exercise. I'm not going to live here. Van whined again. But Uncle Kim has already sent your clothes. Jungkook pointed towards the suitcase that someone had dropped in his apartment a few minutes ago. Van sighed in relief. Then it's okay. I desperately wanted to change my these fancy clothes. Why didn't you tell me that, fiancé? Jungkook didn't want to lose this opportunity to tease her. Oh, fiancé, you are huge and I'm merely a small creature compared to you. Your one shot would be a whole blanket for me. Van tilted him back. Jungkook realized this cute session might be turned into a fight, so he decided to stop and step back. Here is your phone. Someone was calling you from an unknown number in the morning when you were snoring, so I didn't wake you up. I thought it may be urgent, so I picked and that call was disconnected. The very next moment, I called my father-in-law and told him everything. He said it was someone from media. He assured me that he and Dad will take care of everything. When I looked at Jungkook's eyes, he was the first man who was tensed about her safety. She took her phone and checked everything. She checked the clip where Jungkook's deep, husky voice was heard. His voice. The whole feeling was something that brought a smile in her face. What? Dad told me that he and your dad will take care of everything from now? Van sighed. I guess not for always. Jungkook raised an eyebrow playfully. Probably for a week. Will they be able to handle everything? Van asked him. I mean, I know they can, probably better than me, but they haven't done for so many years. I guess they want to give you the back support, so they decided to back in their former routine. Jungkook said. This is the time I dreamt of. Sleep and food and...
Wan was interrupted by Jungkook. Exercise and a healthy lifestyle and a lots of fun, obviously, just for this week. After that, though he wanted to tease her, but the thought of him leaving the country stopped him from completing the sentence. I hope I will make you fall for me, and for me, I have already started falling for you, Wan.